Good afternoon, everyone. Welcome to this lecture of Oracle Database Introduction, and I welcome you all, to batch 56. I'm happy to have you people here. Happy that you people are here, and let's begin the introduction to Oracle Database Administration. Okay. First of all, I would like to start off with the basic examples. Okay. So basic example. So you know, if we go with the Oracle Database Introduction, how this Oracle databases will work and everything, I'll explain you. But before that, I'll give you a diagrammatical or pictorial representation so that you people will actually understand much better. Okay, these are the users. And we have a server here. We have a server. Okay, in this server, we have our Oracle database. We have a database. Basically, we can say there are a lot of databases. So we have databases here. So what is this user and what is this database and everything? First of all, as per the definition of the database, what is a database? Database is nothing but a place where we store our data. And now this data is getting stored here. Okay, fine. But if I want to see the data, how can I see? I have to connect to this database, and then I will be able to get the data on my screen. Right. Now, what is this data and everything? Why this database is very important? Okay, I'll explain you. Let's take a basic example of net banking application. I believe everyone nowadays, without net banking, there's no one here, right? Everyone are having a net banking application with you people. Yes or no? Respond.
Yes, sir.
So if we have to, transfer the money, if we have to do some kind of transactions, or if we have to do anything, net banking is must and should. Yes or no?
Let's say
it could be Google Pay, it could be Phone Pay, it could be anything. Anything we are actually using is nothing but an application. What is that?
Application.
Okay. Anything that we are using is application. So first, who will be there here? First, application will be there. Then the database will come into picture. Okay. First, the application will be there. Then the database will be coming into the picture. So this we call it as apps tier, application tier. Application tier. This we call it as DB tier. DB tier. Okay. This is application tier. This is DB tier. So application and, listen carefully, application and database talks to each other. Okay, without database, no application. Without application, no database. So they both have relation with each other. Even if you have database, how can we see the data? How can we see the data in the database? Using the front-end application only. There should be some front-end application which actually displays the data, right? So that is nothing but application, okay? So how will this application looks like? For example, I'm taking one American Express. I have an American Express account. I use MX. So I'm taking MX account, for example, to show you. This is application. Everyone understand what is an application? This is nothing but an application, right? Net banking application. Everyone understood?
Yes, sir.
This is nothing but a net banking application. Yes. And there will be a username and password. For me, right? So the username and password is stored in the database. So when I click on login, what happens when I click on login from my screen? I'm using this application. When I'm click on login on the screen, the connection is getting established to the database. And after that, once the connection is established, I'm able to see the screen. Now, for example, I want to see what are the last transactions that I have made, basically, or view all recent activity. Okay. When I click on this, it says look at the last login or something. Okay. Now I want to see what are the transactions that I have made in the month of October, for example, October or November. So I'm clicking this dropdown and I'm clicking on select. I'm selecting this dropdown. Now this is the data. This is the data that is getting displayed. From where this data is coming? The data is getting fetched from database and displayed on your screen. The data is fetched from the database and it is displaying on the user's screen. So application is important, as the database is also very important. as the database is also very important. So what happens is the application is getting connected to the database and fetching the data from the database and displaying the data to the user. Understand till here?
Yes, understand.
Yes, yes.
Everyone. So yes. From where this data is coming from, this data is coming from the database only, that I have made some payment and payment received and everything. So the data is getting fetched from the database and it is displaying on your screen, which actually tells you what exactly it is telling. It is telling that now database is very, very important. Why? Not only in the banking application of the banking sector, in each and every sector, database is very, very important to store the data. For example, this is a banking sector example. Now, which I have shown you is a banking sector example. Now, everyone are using net banking application, which means everyone are connecting to the database directly or indirectly without knowing. You people are directly interacting with the database from the back end where your data is stored. From there, the data is getting fetched and displayed on your screen. Okay, so directly or indirectly, you are daily talking to the database. Example number one. Example number two, you go to a medical shop, you go to Apollo Pharmacy. Apollo Pharmacy is nowadays, it's so enhanced in multiple, for every lane, there is one Apollo Pharmacy. Yes or no?
Yes.
So they'll have one common repository. We call it as common database. There will be one common database to maintain all the customers' information. When you go there, compulsory, they'll ask you your phone number, your name, blah, 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 your details and everything. Then they'll give you the bill. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
So when they enter the customer details, the customer details are registered in the Apollo Pharmacy database. So what happens next time when you go, you don't have to tell all the details. If you just give the phone number, the user who is actually using the Apollo Pharmacy application, in the medical shop, you just give the phone number, and if you hit enter, all the customer details will be displayed on the screen. Yes or no? Including your name, your details and everything. Understood? Yes, what sir. I'm talking?
Yes.
Yes, sir. Yes.
So yeah, it is stored in the database. So which means on a day-to-day basis, you're directly or indirectly, you don't know, but you're talking to the database using Apollo Pharmacy as an example. So not only banking sector, the pharmacy sector, which means the medical sector, is also using databases, right? Next comes one more example. How many are using WhatsApp?
Hey, everyone.
What a foolish question, man. You're asking me what a foolish question is this, huh? No, there are some zombies who don't use WhatsApp. There are some zombies. Please, background noise. If you people want to talk, please mute yourself, go outside, happily talk and come back, but not on the sessions. Okay. If you people don't want to listen, that's okay. I don't care. Fine. Anyways, coming back, how many people are using WhatsApp?
Everyone
are using, right? I think not in the previous match, some of the match, that guy is not using WhatsApp. Like I was, okay, fine. Fine. All right. Coming back. So everyone using WhatsApp, right? So now I'll tell you WhatsApp as an example, the entertainment sector, now the entertainment zone or the entertainment sector, medical sector, everyone has to use the database. Banking sector, everyone has to use the database, and entertainment sector. Obviously WhatsApp is an application. WhatsApp is an Android application. It's iOS application. It's a web application. We can use WhatsApp web also. Everyone understood, right? What I'm talking.
Yeah.
So you are the user now. You are the WhatsApp user. You are the WhatsApp user. You have opened a WhatsApp web. You have opened a WhatsApp web. What are the messages that you are actually sending in WhatsApp? You know, what are the messages? The messages is nothing but data. So the data, whatever the messages that you are typing, the messages are getting stored in WhatsApp database. And that WhatsApp databases are actually getting backed up into your Google Drive on a weekly hours, or based on the schedule that you actually keep, weekly or daily, it will be backed up. Yes. Understand what I'm talking?
Yes.
So without knowing that you are talking to a database, but you're talking to a database on a data basis. See, databases are on our day-to-day part of life. Knowingly or unknowingly, you are daily talking to database only. So without database, the world does not exist, I can say. Without a database to store the data, this world does not exist. Even if we think like, okay, so DBAs are top. Yes, DBAs top. I understand. Database administrators, because who are DBAs? Who maintain this data? Who maintain this data are database administrators. Database administrators, and we are database administrators. Yes, DBAs are top, correct. Then what about scientists? Even a scientist needs an application, man, to store his whatever he's doing. Even a scientist needs an application to store the data. You understand what is the importance of database now?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Even if you observe the telecom industry, now coming to the telecom industry, okay, even the Prime Minister of India, the President of India also needs a database to store the data. Understand what I'm talking?
Yes, sir.
Each and every calls that we make, I mean, in general, I'm talking the telecom industry, each and every call are encrypted, and that will be stored in the database in the back end. So how come the CBI will get the data, the call records and everything? The call records will be getting by CBI, right? We hear some news like call records are coming there. We have retrieved the call records, that this blah, blah, blah and everything. I mean, we hear those kind of news, right?
Yes.
From where they are retrieving the calls, from where they are retrieving the data? From database only, man.
Database.
Yes, sir.
So database is nothing but, without a database, the world does not exist. Make this point noted. That's how database is very, very important. Understood?
Sir, understood.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Sir. So now coming to the importance of the database is done. So now you people clearly understood how important the database is, which is good. Okay. Now coming back to the point here. Okay. This is the importance of the database, I mean to say. So how this database works and what are the different type of databases and everything, I'll explain you now. There are different type of databases, like one Oracle database is there. And second is SQL database. Third, there are a lot of databases like Sybase, MongoDB, blah, 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 blah. We only talk about the first two, which is very important. Okay. Like for example, if you want to, I'm telling you one example so that you people will understand very clearly. Somebody has to design this database. Yes or no? Somebody has to design this database.
Yes.
So for example, say we are using, we have ACs in our AC, fridge, or the refrigerator, television, everything we have in our home. So everyone, somebody has to design them, right? Somebody has to make them. We call it as a make and model. If you ask me what is a make and model of the television that I'm using, Sony, Sony Bravia, something like, if we use this make and model, we'll be able to understand. So it's nothing but a brand. Yes or no? We're talking about a brand.
Yes.
Yes.
Yes. Okay.
Yeah.
Okay, fine.
Yes, sir.
Now, if we talk about this brand, if we come to the branding, there are different brands that are available in the market. If we go with the television, there are different brands that are available in the market. Yes or no?
Yes.
Then why am I going for Sony?
It's a brand.
Because it has brand. I mean, there it is a lot of
special features.
Okay.
Special features compared to other.
Picture quality is good.
Who is that? Picture quality. Quality is good.
Mahesh. Volume also.
See, the same 65 inches Sony, if I purchase into some other brand, I'll get for about 60,000 or something. But I want Sony. The reason is quality. It might be cost effective. Oh, it might not be cost effective. It could be 1,25,000 something. But that's okay. But what about the quality? What about the service? What about the the customer service that I'm getting? I'll see a lot of things when I purchase a product. Yes or no? If you purchase, if you purchase a product, you see a lot of things. Yeah. What is the quality that it is giving? Is customer being satisfied? Means, is customer service very good? If I call the customer care, am I getting the customer service within a within spot respective time, within very, very less time? Am I getting my problem resolved from the from the service standpoint and everything? I'll see a lot of things before I purchase a product. Yes or no?
Yes.
So in the same way, databases are designed by multiple products. Oracle is one of the product. SQL is one of the product. Sybase is one of the product. MongoDB, and there are a lot of databases available in the market. But why only Oracle? The same example that I have given you. Quality. Oracle stands first in the market. Oracle stands number one in the market. And Oracle is giving, 90% of the IT organizations are using Oracle products. 90%. So now you understand the value of Oracle databases. 90% of all the organizations are using Oracle databases, including all the sectors that I have told you, all the sectors, not only IT, all the sectors like medical sector, pharma sector, or telecom sector. If you take Vodafone, for example, how many uses Vodafone? I don't know. You go to a Vodafone store, which is now VI. You ask them, when you go and sit in front of them and give you a details, they have the application used by Oracle CRM only. The CRM, which we call it as, they're using Oracle only. Okay. So any company you take, for example, I think you people are working in MNCs. A lot of people who join today, they are actually working people. They're working in some XYZ organization. So you people have to fill in the employee details and everything. I mean, your HR has to fill in the employee details and everything so that you people have to mark your attendance on a weekly basis or daily basis, something, blah, blah, blah. Yeah. I don't know. Yes, right?
Timesheet, I can say.
Timesheet, yeah. So you have to open an application to fill in your timesheet. Yes or no?
Yes.
So obviously, when you fill in the timesheet, where is your timesheet details are stored in the back end? In the database only, man.
Yes.
In the database only. So everyone has to use database, no matter what. Since morning, when we wake up, before we sleep, we are using database. We are actually talking to database, directly or indirectly.
Yes.
Okay. Before we sleep, we use WhatsApp. Once we wake up, we check WhatsApp. How many people do that? I believe everyone, right? I believe everyone are doing the same. Before we sleep, we check our WhatsApp messages and sleep. After we wake up, immediately we check our WhatsApp messages and we say good morning. Yeah?
Yes, sir.
Right. So see, that's what on a day-to-day basis, we're actually talking to the database only, right? So this is how database is very, very important. And as I said, Oracle stands in the first position. Oracle stands in number one position, okay, in the market. Then why not SQL? Why SQL is in the second position? Because Oracle gives a good quality product, a good quality database. Okay, Oracle gives good quality database. Not only good quality, it gives
security.
Exactly. Oracle gives perfect security compared to SQL, compared to SQL database. Because we are playing with data. Data should be very much secure. Can I see your WhatsApp messages?
No.
Can you see my WhatsApp messages?
No.
Very simple. That's a data security. There will not be threat. I can say Oracle databases, hacking Oracle databases is very, very tough job. But recently it happened, Log4j. I'll explain you in upcoming days. That's okay. Oracle databases, hacking Oracle databases is very, very tough. But hacking SQL databases is also tough but a bit easy. Because why? I'll explain you why Oracle is actually very much secured product. Oracle databases are very much secured. Why? Because Oracle databases runs on Linux machine. Oracle databases runs on Linux operating system.
Linux
operating system. And SQL databases runs on Windows, Windows operating system. SQL databases runs on
Windows
operating system. Yes. Okay. Now, if I ask you, hey, can you please move the files from D drive to E drive? Can you people be able to do it? Can you please move? I'm asking you to move. I'm asking you to copy. I'm not asking you to copy. I'm asking you to move. Can you please move the files, some A, B, C files from D drive to E drive?
Will you be able Windows to are to user use? Friendly. Linux needs commands.
No. Wait. I am the trainer. I'll explain you. Okay. I'm asking you a question. Directly answer the question. Okay. If I'm asking you people to move files, A, B, C files from D drive to E drive, will you people able to do it or not? Very simple.
Yes, sir.
Yeah.
If I ask the same question, can you people move the files in Linux operating system? Will you people be able to do it?
No.
Because no. People don't know Linux.
Yeah.
Yes, I know.
Even if I ask a kid also, a kid will be able to do Windows on Windows, but not on Linux. That's how secured Linux is. Now I'll tell you what is the difference. The difference is, as one of our person said, yeah, it's a command line interface, but even if it is a command line interface, we have a graphical interface also to copy, paste, to move the folders or to move the, there's a graphical also. But the main purpose of using a Linux operating system is Linux is very much secure than Windows. We use Linux operating system to store our databases. There should be a platform, right? I said server. This is a Linux server. In Linux server, we will keep our Oracle databases. In Linux server, we'll keep our Oracle databases. So that the data is very much secured. Understand the point?
Yes, sir.
Understand the point, right?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So, So that's one point about the security. So that's how, you know, most of the companies are using Linux operating system. Most of the companies are using Linux operating system here, right? And what else? After the security and the importance of Oracle databases is completed. Now we'll see what are the things that we have to use to create an Oracle database. To create an Oracle database, what are the things that we need? Now, first thing that we need is VMware. Second thing we need is Linux. Third thing that we need is Oracle software. Okay. And then we will create Oracle database. Then we'll create Oracle database. Okay. So this is how we actually do it. Okay. Now, you people can ask me, what is VMware? What is a VMware? First, we'll talk about VMware. Now, everyone understood what is a Linux, right? Linux is nothing but operating system. Just like Windows operating system, Linux is a operating system. Understand, everyone?
Yes, sir.
So once we install VMware, then we install Linux. Once we install Linux, then we install Oracle software. Once we install Oracle software, then we create Oracle database. This is our procedure. Now coming to the VMware, I'll talk one to one here from so that you people will understand. What is a VMware? I'll explain you what is a VMware. Now there are two things which you have to understand. The difference between a VM and a physical machine. So before we proceed, how many people in the batch know about VMware? Tell me. Anyone of you know what is VMware?
No.
Okay, great.
No idea.
Okay, no problem. If you people don't know, that is happy. Okay, because I can explain you in a very better way so that you people will understand. Okay. Half knowledge is very dangerous actually. I'll give you full knowledge, don't worry. So the VMware, what is this VMware? I'll explain you. How this VMware looks also, I'll explain you. This is how the VMware looks. This is how the VMware looks, and this we call it as a VMware workstation. We call it as VMware workstation, okay? And all these are servers. Linux servers. All these are Linux servers, okay? Now, I'll explain you what is the difference between a physical machine and a virtual machine. For example, if my server is in a virtual machine now. My servers, all the servers are in virtual machine. This one, two, this. All these servers are in virtual machine now. Okay. All these servers are in virtual machine, meaning my Linux operating system, is in virtual machines. But for example, if physical machine, what is a physical machine? My laptop is nothing but a physical machine. Understand what is a physical machine? My laptop, your laptop, everyone's laptop is nothing but a physical machine.
Yes.
You understood, right? Yes. What I'm talking?
Yes.
Yes.
Okay. Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
They're nothing but physical machines. So I'll explain you the difference between a physical machine and a virtual machine here. So for example, instead of my Windows operating system, I have a Linux laptop. For example, consider that this is my laptop. In which I have installed Linux. I did not install Windows. This is not my Windows laptop. I have installed Linux. Now we are using Linux operating system directly, without a VMware. I'm using directly. Now my databases are in, for example, some D drive. My databases are in D drive. All the databases are in D drive and E drive. Now databases are in D drive and E drive. Now suddenly, this laptop, where is this server? A laptop is nothing but a server, man. But it's a physical server. Remember that point. Physical server. Laptop is a physical server. I mean, my operating system is a physical machine. Physical server. My server is a physical server. And my databases are in D drive and E drive. Fine. Now the server, the physical machine, this laptop, the physical server is in US. Okay. It's in US. And all the users are in India. They're connecting with the help of IP address of this machine. What is the IP address of this machine? I can get the IP address of my machine. How many people know the IP address of how to get IP address?
Yes, sir, I know, sir.
IP config,
sir.
Okay. So this is my machine IP address, 192.168.1.6. So with the help of IP address, how people will connect? Like this. Remote desktop connection, they'll give the IP address here, 192.168.1.1.6, and they give enter. Okay, so they'll connect like that. All users will connect like that. Okay, and everyone are able to see my screen, right?
Yes, sir.
Now I'll explain you the difference. Now all people are connected. Okay, all users are connected. As I was talking about, you know, connection, all users are connected to the database. And the database, this complete server, this physical server, this is a physical server. Assume that this is a physical server, not a virtual. This is a physical server, okay? And this physical server, this server is in US. And all the users are in India. And they're able to connect to the server and the databases. Now all the databases are okay. The connections are going on. And now the work is in progress. Suddenly, the server went down. Why? There could be charging problem. If it is charging is completely done, the server will be down. Means my laptop will be down. Yes or no?
Yes.
Everyone able to understand what I'm talking? Can you please people respond?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Even if I want to down this, how can I down my server? How can I shut down my server? Just by clicking on shutdown, laptop will be shut down. Yes or no?
Yes.
Yes.
Okay. But where is this physical machine located in? In which location?
United States.
Yes.
But where are the users?
India.
Right. Where is DBA? DBA is also sitting in India. For example, DBA is also sitting in India. Okay. DBA who manages this database also sitting in India. Okay. And the server is in US. Now suddenly the server is down. How to bring the server back online? Tell me.
No idea.
Your laptop is down, man. Your laptop is down.
Charge.
Huh?
We have to power it on back.
No, we need to rectify where there is issue.
What I'm asking you, simple question, simple answer.
Switch on the power.
Your laptop is shut down. Your laptop is shut down, meaning your server is shut down. Now, how to bring this server back online is my question.
We have to power on the laptop again.
Charge the charger.
What are you talking,
Ashita? You have to charge the laptop because
No, charging the laptop is okay. I have charged now, but how to power on the server?
Sir, where laptop is open, Jessica, sir?
Someone has to go physical.
Someone has to go to the location physically. And what I have to do, if this physical machine is going down, as a DBA, what I have to do, I have to talk to my management. I have to ask a flight ticket to US. I have to go to US. Okay. I have to go to US one day complete. I have to travel and I have to go to US. I have to land in US. I have to enjoy in US. I have to do sightseeing and go to the data center where the server is there. And there will be a power button on your laptop. Just you have to go and press the power button. What I'm talking
about? Will
any company accept this? If the physical server is going down, will any company give the flight ticket to go to US and just for clicking the power on button?
No,
right?
So this time we use virtual machine.
That is why we use virtual machine. What is the benefit of virtual machine is, for example, there is one server. I can power on. Is my laptop on or off right now?
On.
But virtual machine?
Before it was off, now it's on.
Now it's very easy, user friendly to power on, power off. Am I going to US right now?
No.
Simple. Understand the difference between virtual machine and a physical machine?
Yes, sir.
So now our Linux machine, this is Linux operating system. This is a Linux operating system. All the Linux servers we use will be in virtual machines. They will not be in physical machines. Understand now?
Yes, sir.
This point is clear?
Yes.
Okay. So that is VMware. So that's why we use VMware. Now Linux. Coming to Linux operating system. There are different versions of Linux operating system. We don't have to worry about different versions of Linux operating system. That's okay. We have to install Linux in VMware. We have to install Enterprise Linux in VMware. I'll show you the installation process. Don't worry. And then after the Linux is installed, we'll install Oracle software. Then we'll create the database. Now we'll talk about the Oracle software. How many versions of Oracle software are there? There are different versions. 11G. Starting with 9i, 10G, 11G, 12G, 18G. 19C, like that.
Okay.
The latest version is 19C. So I'll explain you about the versions now. Versions. What are the versions in Oracle? Starting with 9i. Not starting with 9i. I started my career with 9i. I started my career with 9i. Then 10G. Then 11G. 11G also release 1. 11G release 2. Okay. 12C release 1.12C, release 2, 18C, 19C, like this. Latest version is 19C. We start our courses from 11G release 1. In 11G release 1 also, we have different versions. How the versions will be is in release 1 will be 11.1.0.1, 11.1.0.2, like this. okay, like this 11.1.0.2, 0.3, 0.4, like this. We use 11.1.0.6 to start our course. To start our course with, we use 11.1.0.6. Then we move to 11. Here in 11th release 2, it will be 11.2.0.1. Okay, like that. If it goes on, it will be going like this till 0.4. Okay, and then 12C, we have 12C release 1 starts with 12.1.0.1. Okay, and it goes on like 12.1.0.2. Release 2 starts like 12.2.0. And 18C starts with 18.1, 18.2, 19C, 19.1. Still 19.2 is not released, I think. 19.1. We are using 19.1.10. 19.1.0.10. Yeah. Understood versions of Oracle?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Okay. So we are starting a version with 11.1.0.6. Okay, we'll be starting a version with 11.1.0.6, and then we slowly will upgrade to 11.0.2.3, and then 12C, then all the rack will do in 19C. Okay, and after the software installation is completed, we'll create the database. We'll create the database. Okay. Now, what is the language that we are using? What is the language that we are using? Okay. There are a lot of languages like C, C++, Java, Python, you know, there are a lot of languages in the market available, and what is the coding that we do and everything. Okay. Don't be panicked, guys. No coding. Oracle database has no coding. Feel free, feel happy. Okay. Then what is the language that we are using here? I'm using English to communicate with you people, right? I'm using English to communicate with you people so that you people are able to understand my language. In the same way, we talk to a language, we talk to database in such a language that database has to understand. The language is SQL, structured query language, which is nothing but English. If you people know English, structured query language is very easy. So English is required. That's it. There's no Java, there's no Python, blah, 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 nothing required here. No coding, it's a zero coding. Oracle Database Administration is a zero coding. Who will do the coding? Developers. So who are developers? For example, people who design the application, who build the application. For example, if you see source code, you pay source code, okay? So this is nothing but coding. This is the code. This is the code, HTML code. Who will write all this code? Developers. It's not DBAs. It's not DBAs who write the code. Okay. The developers write the code and develop the application. Then what is the job of DBA? To maintain the data inside the database is nothing but the job of a DBA. Understand?
Yes.
Okay. Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. That's why DBAs are highly paid in the market. They are very, very highly paid in the market. DBA salaries are very high. Why? Reason is, without database, the world does not exist, as I told you. I have shown you many examples with proofs, right? So DBAs are highly paid. If you go to the market, okay, Oracle DBAs are very highly paid. The reason is, if you go to a project, if you go to any IT company and if you go to any project, okay, if you see 10 Oracle DBAs, you will see one SQL DBA. So that is 1:10 ratio. Means for a project, you need 10 employees Oracle DBAs and one SQL DBA. So that will be the difference. So Oracle DBA jobs are very, very high in the market. And I believe you people already heard yesterday or day before yesterday, a lot of interview calls also happening, right? How many people heard that?
One guy got 9.2. 9.2.
Yeah. So a lot of people actually, interviews are in progress for the previous batches. So there'll be a lot of openings for Oracle database, which is one of the advantage of taking Oracle Database Administration. Okay. And that's it for the day. Okay. So tomorrow, what we will do is there are some more things that I have to explain. This is about the introduction to Oracle Database, why we use Oracle Database and what are the different versions and everything. Tomorrow, I'll explain you. There are three modules that we are going to cover. Okay. There are three modules. Module number one, core database administration. This core database admission. Module number two, data card administration. Module number three, rack. There are three modules that we are going to cover. Okay, there are three modules that we are going to cover. Okay, what are these three modules? Tomorrow I'll explain you. Tomorrow I'll explain you about the three modules so that we'll have a quick understanding about the three modules, and then we'll wrap it up with the introduction. This half introduction is completed. Tomorrow I'll give you half introduction about the course. This is about the overview of Oracle Database. Tomorrow I'll give you the course introduction. This is overview of Oracle Database. Tomorrow I'll introduce the course. Like what are the three modules that we are going to cover and why we have to learn those three modules. Tomorrow I'll cover. So by tomorrow ends the introduction. And after that, from Monday onwards, we'll start installing one by one. VMware, Linux, Oracle, and the practicals and theory starts from Monday. So tomorrow we are going to cover the course introduction tomorrow. Understand?
Okay, sir.
Yes.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Clear, right? How is the class? I mean, crystal clear? Is it clear or normal clear?
Crystal clear.
Fine, guys.
And very good examples.
Okay. Yeah. So anyways, like the feedback will be asked in the group. So please write your valuable feedback, whatever you feel like. I'll give you the feedback form and everything. That's okay. Other than that, like this is the end of the session. And now I have 5 minutes of the time, okay, for Q&A. And you people can ask any questions. Feel free to ask me any questions you have, not only related to the course, something related to the career, blah, blah, blah. You people have a lot of things, right? So you ask me, I have 5 minutes of time starting from now. Your Q&A starts right now. One by one, please don't come all group at a time. Okay. When someone is talking, just let them talk and give them time so that I'll be answering also all your questions. And other than that, I have nothing to share today. Thank you so much for your valuable time, joining the lecture, and hope we meet in the upcoming classes and your career will be very bright, and all the best for your future and, for your career and everything. Hope you people learn more and more and get a job as soon as possible. And I'll definitely give my best to help you people to get a job, right? So now you can start asking your question and answers. Other than that, I have nothing to share. Thank you so much.